Next one we have to discuss about the Newton's law of gravitation, means law of gravitation. Next one is Coulomb's inverse square law. Coulomb's inverse square law in electrostat as well as in magnetostats. First one is law of gravitation, means Newton's law of gravitation. The gravitational force or the attractive force between any two massive particles, means let we have to take in two particles of masses, means m1 and m2 are separated by a distance, it is indicated by small d or r, small r. So let we have to take into the distance between two particles of d. So the attractive force between two massive particles in the m1 m2 we have to also taken to different masses, capital M and small m, also we have to take in the terms instead of m1 m2. So the attractive force between two massive particles, attractive force, force, so it is represented by F. So the attractive force is directly proportional to product of the two masses, means m1 into m2, equation number 1. And the attractive force between two masses, F, is inversely proportional to square root of distance between the m1 and m2. The distance between two particles is represented by small d or small r. So I have to take into small d is the distance between m1 and m2. So F is inversely proportional to 1 by d square. Equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, we can write the equation F proportional to m1 m2 by d square. Okay, from equation 1 and 2, F proportional to m1 m2 by d square. Let equate the equation, means we have to eliminate the proportionality. So F is equal to some constant k m1 m2 by d square, where k is equal to g. G is called universal gravitational constant. So the formula F is equal to g m1 m2 by d square. The equation is called Newton's law of gravitation. Next one, the g value, g is called universal gravitational constant. So g is equal to 6.67 into 10 power minus 11 Newton meter square per kg square. Next one, as well as the second law, Coulomb's inverse square law. Instead of two massive particles, m1, m2, we have to take in two charges. Charge is represented by Q. So let we have to take in two charges. Two charges are represented by Q1 and Q2. The distance between two charges, it is represented by R. So the attractive or the repulsive force, means the Coulomb force, F, is directly proportional to product of two charges, means F proportional to Q1 into Q2. Equation number 1. The distance between two charges, it is represented by small r or d. So the Coulomb force, attractive force or repulsive force, is inversely proportional to square root of distance between two charges, means F is inversely proportional to 1 by r square. Equation number 2. From equation 1 and equation number 2, let we have to write F proportionality Q1 Q2 by r square. Next one, as usual, F proportional to m1 m2 by d square. So equate the equation, means let we have to remove the, eliminate the proportionality. So F is equal to some constant k. K is called proportionality constant. K q1 q2 by r square, where k is constant, k value is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. So F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q Q1 Q2 by R square. So the equation is called Coulomb's inverse square law in electrostats or electricity. F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R square. So the constant value K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, where epsilon naught value, epsilon is nothing but permittivity of free space. The value epsilon value is equal to 8.854 into 10 power minus 12 Coulomb square per Newton meter square. So epsilon is the free space permittivity, permittivity of vacuum. Next one, where K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, the value is equal to 9 into 10 power 9. K value are the 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught value, 9 into 10 power 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. So the equation is called Coulomb's inverse square law in electrostat or electricity. In the same manner, in order to explain the Coulomb's inverse square law in magnetism, so in the law of gravitation we have to take it m1 m2 means to different masses. In the electrostatic we have to take it to different charges q1 q2. In the magnetism I have to take it to different pole strength, north south, south north, north north, south south. So the pole strengths are represented by m1 and m2. The distance between two pole strength, it is represented by d. So the attractive or repulsive force F is proportional to product of two pole strength, F proportional to m1 m2, equation number 1. As usual, F is inversely proportional to square root of distance between the m1 m2. So it is represented by equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, let me have to write the equation F proportional to m1 m2 by d square. Next one, we can equate the equation, means we can remove the eliminality. Proportionality, F is equal to K some constant, K is called proportionality constant, m1 m2 by d square, where K is nothing but mu naught by 4 pi. So F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi m1 m2 by d square. The equation is called Coulomb's inverse square law in magnetism. So where K is the constant, constant value is equal to mu naught by 4 pi. Where mu naught is the constant word, mu naught permeability of free space. So mu naught is equal to 4 pi into 10 power minus 7 entry per meter. So the three equations are, means law of gravitation equation, F is equal to G m1 m2 by d square. This is called Newton's gravitational law. When the two massive particles separated by a distance some d or r. Second one is the Coulomb's inverse square law in electrostats, electricity. When the two charges are, different charges are, like charges are, unlike charges are, separated by a distance small r. So F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon q1 q2 by r square. And then next one is, we have to take in pole strength, north south, south north, like this. So two pole strengths are differentiated by the distance, some distance separated by some distance d or r. Then the equation F is equal to mu naught by 4 pi m1 m2 by d square. The equation is called Coulomb's inverse square law in magnetism. In the magnetism, constant value is mu naught, permeability of free space. In the electricity, the constant value is epsilon naught, permittivity of free space. In the law of gravitation, the constant value is G. G is nothing but, it is called universal gravitational constant. Okay, students, thank you.